बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। होप डेट यू ऑल विल बी फाइन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ सेकंड लेक्चर फॉर कंप्यूटर ग्रेड फाइव। सो स्टूडेंट्स, ओपन योर बुक विद मी। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट यूनिट नंबर वन, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इट्स एक्सरसाइज। सो वी विल मूव टूवर्ड्स अवर सेक्शन ए, विच इज़ अबाउट फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स। सो द नंबर वन इज़ माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड्स प्रोवाइड विद डैश प्रूफिंग फीचर्स डेट विल हेल्प प्रोड्यूस प्रोफेशनल एरर फ्री डॉक्यूमेंट्स। So the answer is several. Microsoft Word provides with several proofing features. Number two is, to make your document appear professional, you will like to make sure that it is free from dash and grammar errors. So the answer is spelling and grammar errors. Number three is, you can run a spelling and grammar check, press dash shortcut key. We have studied that we will press F7 key for checking off spelling and grammar errors. So the answer is F7. Number four is, by default, MS Word dash checks your document for spelling and grammar errors. So the answer is automatically. Number five is, spelling errors are indicated dash wavy lines. So the answer is colored wavy lines. Section B is about tick the correct option. So number one is, a word processor would most likely be used to: option A, keep an account of money spent; option B, do a computer search in media center; option C, maintain an inventory; and option D, type a biography. So the right answer is option number B, do a computer search in media center. Option number two is, autocorrect was originally designed to replace dash words as you type. So option A is short, repetitive; option B, grammatically incorrect; option C, misspelled; option D, none of the above. So the right answer is option B, grammatically incorrect. Number three is, which of the following are word processing software? Option A, WordPerfect; option B, EasyWord; option C, MS Word; option D, all of the above. So the right answer is option C, MS Word. Number four is, which file starts MS Word? Option A, winword.exe; option B, word.exe; option C, msword.exe; option D is word2003.exe. So the right answer is option A, winword.exe. Number five is, you can detect spelling and grammar errors by: option A, press Shift plus F7, option B, press Control plus F7, option C, press Alt plus F7, option D, press F7. So the right answer is option D, press F7. Now we will move towards section C, which is about answer the following questions. Number one is, what are the uses of spelling and grammar feature? So the answer is, it helps to check spelling and grammar mistakes. It indicates the word in a document which may be misspelled or incorrect. You have to note down the complete answers in your notebooks. Now the question number two is, how to open a spelling and grammar dialog box? I have mentioned the answers page number for your easiness. So the answer is on page number four. We have to move towards page number four. Right here, there is the answer of question number two. Note down the steps. Go to the review tab. Click on the spelling and grammar command. The spelling and grammar dialog box will open. This is the complete answer of question number two. Now, the question number three is, how would you change the automatic spelling and grammar check settings? So its answer is on page number six. You have to move towards page number six. Note down the steps. From file menu, click option commands. Select proofing. The dialog box gives you several options to choose from. If you don't want MS Word to automatically check spelling, uncheck check spellings as you type. If you don't want grammar errors to be marked, uncheck mark grammar errors as you type. To check for contextual spelling errors, check use contextual spelling. Now the question number four is, how would you hide spelling and grammar errors in a document? So its answer is on page number eight. You have to move towards page number eight. Note down the steps. From file menu, click option commands. Select proofing. In the drop down box next to exceptions for, select the correct document. Put a check mark next to hide spelling errors in this document only and hide grammar errors in this document only. Click OK button. The last question is, how would you use the grammar check features? answer is right click the underlined word or phrase, a menu will appear. Click the correct phrase from the listed suggestions. The corrected phrase will appear in the document. You can also choose to ignore an underlined phrase. Now, the last section is about tick in the relevant box. Number one is the red line indicates a misspelled word. So, the statement is true. We have to tick in the true box. The green line indicates a contextual spelling error. No, the statement is false. So, we have to tick in the false box. Number three is the blue line indicates a grammatical error. So, the statement is also false. We have to tick in the false box. Number four is contextual spelling error features are turned off by default. The statement is true. So, we have to tick in the true box. Last one is press F7 key to open spelling and grammar dialog box. So, the statement is false. We have to tick in the false box. It was all about today's lecture. Inshallah, in next lecture, we will study about unit number 2. Allah Hafiz, fi manillah.